Para sa glorification?
Yes. Yes.
Right. Sabi ng Bible, this is just God, no?
That's right.
Let's turn to 1 Peter chapter 3, verse 9. 2 Peter chapter 3. 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 9. The Lord is not concerning His promises as some men count slackness, but is long-suffering toward us, not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance. So everybody is on the same basis.
That's right.
Why He said this in this word, that Esau I hate and Jacob I love?
You already saw it.
Huh?
Yes, you are.
Again?
He already saw it because of his pornography.
Yeah. So again, you trace back to pornography.
Right.
Even the baby is not yet born.
Amen.
If you look at it in a literal way, you will say that there is injustice with God. But God, you see the life of Esau, you see the life of Jacob. See? Jacob is a worse fellow than Esau.
That's right.
But he is concerned with his birthright.
Yes,
right.
That's why in the beginning, before the child was born, the birthright should belong to Esau. But he don't care for it.
Amen.
Jacob cared for his birthright no matter what he do.
Amen.
He go to the extent of cheating his father, right?
Amen.
Using his mother, mas buya si Jacob. So there is no unrighteousness with God. How many you are here? Do you believe that God foresaw you before the foundation?
Yes, amen.
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 Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you. Hallelujah. So predestination. It's not the way you think it. Gusto ko nito, ayoko nito, gusto ko nito, ayoko nito. It's not the way you think it. By the way, listen to this very carefully. According to the Bible, according to the message, you have a free will, right?
Yes.
Because God does not touch your free will.
Yes.
Right? You say amen to that. God is not touching your free will.
Right.
And accept Jesus Christ, and accept the message, you can throw the message, whatever you want. So, when the message comes to you, right? When the message comes to you, why did you accept? Hindi pa naman naiintindihan yung message, yung simula. There's nobody that come to the message that understood the message in the very first time that he came. Bakit yung tinanggap?
Because he didn't predestinate.
Akala ko ba? So you are predestined to glorification. That's the meaning of it, right?
Amen.
So, akala ko ba hindi humimili ang Panginoon?
Humimili? Because of the
sin. He chose you because he saw it already.
Ano ba, namimili o hindi?
Namimili.
Yes.
Yes, amen.
He chose you.
Yes.
See?
Because he know that you...
Pero, listen, iba, listen, predestination for the bride, iba sa predestination sa
outside. Right.
Right. Right.
Amen.
Right.
You say amen to that.
Amen.
Amen.
If you are a bride of Jesus Christ, meron ka na walang free will.
Yes.
Yes, that's true.
Meron ka na wala.
Right.
Absolutely. Kasi
hindi ka mo. Oo na parang.
Absolutely.
Absolutely. Because you cannot say yes, you cannot say no to that.
Yes.
When the message of our hour come to you, you cannot say no to that.
Yes.
There's something in you that say yes.
Yes. God, there's something on you.
Amen. Thank you.
So that predestination, you are predestined to say yes.
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 Yes. Yes.
Correct?
Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Ang predestination sa bride, iba sa predestination sa labas.
That's right.
May mga naka-predestined. There's somebody who is predestined outside of the city. There's
yes.
Also predestined to eternity.
Yes, yes, that's right.
But they were not given this. I may call it amazing grace.
Amen.
Amazing grace.
They were not given the grace to know all of these things.
Oh.
All that you're hearing from, all that you're hearing from this pulpit, come from the grace of God.
Amen. Amen.
You cannot hear this message outside of this church.
Amen.
So you're very, very, you don't know only who you are.
Yes.
Sabi ng prophet, you know, the bride knows who you are and you can speak a universal existence.
That's right. You
know earlier your position.
Amen.
So, labas na
yun.
Sarap, sarap. Ano yung mga
yung
if God, di siya namimili, hindi pa siya na, if God is choosing for predestination, for the glorification, see? So a person, if he is destined for destruction, is to will induce you?
No.
Did God like to be, sabi kaya, not willing that any, he's not willing that anyone should perish.
Yes.
And come to knowledge of the truth and repentance.
Yes. He did it because he knows that they will choose it.
But in our time, in our environment, when you share the gospel, you will know whom they are this time.
That's right.
That's why the bride of Jesus Christ, we are the most privileged person.
Amen.
To understand the revelation.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Sa salita pa lang yung kausap mo, alam mo mali siya sa
akin. Amen.
Kaya na nakakalukot ka kami. Gusto natin masipila natin. Kaya nga kami, maayo kami, Bible study kami, nagkaanap kami ng mga. So far, zero pa rin kami.
That's true.
Hallelujah. Salamat kayo sa Panginoon. There is a message of the hour. Huwag kayong manlalabi. Don't feel the coldness of this season, because this season is cold. Lukewarm. Bible prophesies it, because thou are lukewarm. Either you'll be hot or cold. See, you should be hot, or you should be cold. Kay lukewarm. Ayon ng Panginoon ng lukewarm.
That's right.
Hallelujah. So if you say you are predestined, sasabihin mo, ito hindi. Hallelujah. Paano mo nalalaman hindi siya predestined? Katulad nung, let's say, the people that we go going to the Bible study, we know that they are not predestined.
No.
He knows. Although they are very
sincere
in what they are doing,
more
sincere than us. Because according to their health,
every day.
On the Saturday they are resting. The whole week,
every day.
Bible study, one worship, and they don't know the message in the Lord. Hallelujah. Salamat kayo sa Panginoon. Meron lang sa ayin. Sabihin kayo sa Panginoon. Brother Dick, you found it.
Yes, amen.
Hallelujah. Be careful in opening the scripture because you might misplace the scripture.
That's right.
Dios.
That's right.
You must place the word as you have to place it. Otherwise, you will misplace the scripture. How many people now outside of this church misplacing the scripture? And just mabait lang yan.
Amen.
This long suffering the world has.
That's right.
It's given grace. See? Pero mind it, the time of God is not your time.
Amen. That's right.
Maaaring ikaw, nahihinip ka na, tagad naman ni Lord. Remember, 1,000 years, one day.
That's right.
Ikaw, wala ka pang isang kalating oras sa Panginoon.
Hallelujah.
See, mga ibang tao, they don't even have time to serve the Lord, to raise their hand, clap their hand, to sing, worship to the Lord. Hallelujah. Kaya yung pagkukuyo dyan, yung pag-iyak-iyak niyo, pagpalakpak niyo, hindi sayang sa Diyos yan.
Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. Amen.
Eh, yung isla na mayroong pera sa bibig, alam ng Diyos eh.
That's right.
Diyan? Right. Yeah. Sabi niya, wala tayong pabayad ng temple tax, sabi ni Lord. Go to the sea, mamimit ka ron. Yung staff, mayroong silver na coin. Tama na po ba yun? Paano niya nalaman yun?
He knows. That's a good
sign.
Buti ba yung Diyos nakakaintindi ng language? Ang Diyos na nakakaintindi ng language ng Diyos.
Amen.
Yung tao, di ba kaintindi ng
language?
Hallelujah.
And animals did not change from the beginning. Yung pipit, pipit pa rin.
Amen.
Right? Yung maya, maya pa rin. Yung lapu-lapu pa rin siya.
Hallelujah.
At human being is not the same. Yung lalaki naging bakla.
Yung
babae naging tomboy.
It's true.
Salamat kayo sa grace sa Panginoon at
Panginoon.
Naintindihan niyo yung presentation. Namimili, ang Diyos namimili. Namimili siya na hindi.
Amen. Because you know what you will do. That's why.
In the very first place that you come to the message, you don't know anything.
Correct.
Right? And then, what make you understand the message?
Because God
made you understand. Yes. Because you are built that way to understand His nature.
Thank you.
Kaya ang Bible, you cannot go to school, you cannot go to theology, you cannot go to seminary, you cannot go to DVD, whatsoever.
Amen.
Master the Bible, because the Bible cannot be understood in school. It will be understood only by the revelation of the Word of God in you.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And it is already only impounded to special class of people.
Amen.
Brother Ernest, special sa Panginoon.
Amen. Yes. Right.
Brother Albert, special sa Panginoon.
Amen.
You don't feel special to yourself, right? Because you're just living a natural life.
Amen.
There's nothing special to us.
That's right.
Hallelujah. But according to my Bible, you are special
to
us.
Amen.
Yes. Say amen to that.
Amen.
You are all special
for
God.
Amen.
Kaya mag-paint yung paint ninyo.
That's right.
Yeah. Itong ginagawa natin, every week, you're hearing the word of God, increase your faith.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. Increase your understanding.
Amen.
Yes, amen.
Thank you, Lord. Stand for the worship.
How great is our God? How great is our God? Amen. Wala sa listahan, pero hindi po ang Panginoon para kantayin yun. Tayo po din ang mga pangyarihan ng Panginoon.
Amen.
Amen.
And
When we're given Thank you. You're the one who Thank you. Binabalik niyo po, Panginoon, binabalik niya ang kanyang mga kabila sa kanyang mga pugad. Maraming maraming salamat at niniyakap po sila na makabalik niyo po. Si Sista Brother Vicky, ngayon. Sino po ang pinagpala sa
magandang umaga mga kapatid. Matagal ng panahon, hindi kami yakot tumayo ulit dito sa harapan. At ako'y nagagala sa araw na to. At mating naman yung isang taon sa buhay ko. Matagal na naman ang aking edad. Sa edad ng 39, hindi ko lupo sa kalay na damor na nagkakaedad ko tayo. Damor na blessed tayo. Lalo na nung tinanggap natin ating mga na Panginoon. Ang edad natin is only a number. Number 39. Pero walang-walang kasing tamis ang tinanggap natin ng ating mga. Tunay nakita ko, pinakita ng Panginoon, tunay na mayaman tayo bilang sa
Kristo.
Mayaman sa mga pagsubok. Kung paano yung nakikita ang malakapingit ang aming mga anak, mas sigis ko ang mga pagsubok na pinagdaanan namin. Yung na may mga madilim na nangyari sa buhay namin hanggang sa maraming salamat sa ating malapanis na paggabay niya at patuloy pa rin kami nangahawakan sa kanyang salita. At huwag niyong isipin na masaya pag nakikita, pero sa likod ng ating likod, sa likod ng ating buhay ay meron din tayong pinagdadaan, kanyang pinagdadaan. At maraming salamat. Blessing lahat yan na dumating. Yeah. Blessing din sa mga pagpapalam. Dumating nato. Tunay nga po na manahin lang natin siya. At mabalas na simple ang pangarap, hindi natin alam na masigit pala ang kanyang binibigay. Alam niya ang puso ng bawat isa sa amin. At sa oras na to, matagal na rin ang panahon, hindi kami nag-alay ng isang awitin. Gusto na mag-alay ng isang awitin. Punta dito sa Arapan. At next Friday po pala, hinihiko po ang mga mission ng ating malakabatid, ang ating pastor na nandiyan po kayo. Gusto po sana, kagalakan po namin ang aking pamilya na gusto po sana mag-swimming tayo sa sea line sa next Friday after ng gawain. Kung sino pong makakadalo, gusto po kami matutuwa. Mga kapatid, kung alam niyo po yung tantang ito, bali, hindi ko sinamit alam mo yung There is Hope in the Night by Greg Lowe. So po kasi yung aming ang pamasok sa aming puso na gusto niya alay.
dreams from encouragement when you don't know what to do. Wondering how the life could be so good. I have failed to be like you, and I have made it through by holding on to someone who wants to hold you through.
There is hope in the night. When the darkness hides the day, hope for your heart. When the fears hide your faith, listen to the one who says everything will be alright. Don't give up. There is hope in the night.
Mga
buhay mo. No, guys, mga kapatid, gusto po kayo. Habang panahon na hindi tayo nagkasama. Gusto ko lang po i-share yung naging vacation ko. Ganda po naman yung naging sitwasyon. Although malayo po yung gawain doon. Ano po pala, pinaparating po ng ating kapatid na kumusta na po tayo dito. Pastor po doon, si Brother Panin. Sinatuloy po ako dumadalo, kasama ko po doon si Brother Roger. Ang gawain po doon, medyo talagang malayo po. Hindi ka po gagawa ng report more than, mas siguro 50 kilometers, tatlong bayan ang pupuntahan mo. Napakahirap po ang gawain ng layo. At napapasalamat ako sa Panginoon sapagkat binibigyan niya ako ng patuloy na desire na akong makalala. Sinishare ko lang po sa mga kapatid kasi pag umuwi po tayo doon, maghanap po tayo ng gawain. At napapasalamat ako sa Panginoon na binibayan niya ako yung init na nararamdaman ko lagi ng doon. Lord, help us. At doon naman, battle ko yung pamilya ko. Ayon din na sumunod. Kasi hindi ko pa-witness po sila. Yun lang po ang masasabi ko mga kapatid. Patuloy lang po tayo. Salamat po sa Panginoon.
Ang pangabuti ng Panginoon at kahit gano'n man kalayo ang pinupunta ng ating kapatid na talaga umiling po siya na magpatuloy ang kanyang pananampalataya sa Panginoon. Tinatawag mo po rin si Brother Robby.
Oh yeah. Blessed be the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Gusto ko sana mag-testimony sa Tagalog para mas madali magdala po tayo ng ibang lahi. And I would like to thank our Lord Jesus Christ. Actually, since last week, I would like to thank you since we came from vacation that our God is a living God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. But there's no opportunity last week since we have a lot of brethren. Sister Mila, binabati po rin pa natin sa kanyang pagbabalik. We didn't meet with Sister Mila because we know that when we were in vacation, we have a lot of things to settle for our loved ones. Especially we are concerned for the soul of our loved ones. And I'd like to thank our Lord Jesus Christ that sometimes others cannot understand, even especially my wife cannot understand our short vacation, that it is unexpected that we went home. And I'm praying always to the Lord that for whatever is the will of the Lord, so it is done. And actually, I have no plan actually to go for vacation this month because I'm preparing for the enrollment of my son for this June. And but the thing is, it is also my desire in the other part to go for vacation because I would like to meet with my family again to impart the redemption, the grace that God has been given to us. Since my father is still not yet a believer, and my two brothers and one sister, were all baptized before, but they are not in the fellowship in this moment. So, then I pray to the Lord that for whatever is the will of the Lord, so be it done. And I pray to the Lord until on the last week of April, sorry, on March, and it just came into my heart just to check for a booking, and it comes into my heart to go for even short vacation. And when I told to my wife, just checked for the booking for the first week of April, and then when she checked, there's an opportunity with a low ticket cost, and so I told her just book for it. And when I went home, I tried to book, but it was not successful for the first attempt. Then, until the time that I still continued to pray to the Lord, and then it was successful. And without any preparation, less than a week that we went for, decided to go for vacation, and went for vacation, without any preparation at all. And then, when we went vacation, I prayed to the Lord before going for reaching Philippines that my vacation will not be in vain. It will be consumed for for the needs of my loved ones. And then even the application, I pray to the Lord that we will be have a simple family reunion with my loved ones. Initially, my father was in Manila, and then I told him, just wait for a couple of three days, because we will be complete here with all of us here, so that we'll have a simple gathering, only just to be fellowship with them, to talk with them. At the same time, I pray to the Lord that the Lord will open the word for them. But my father, he did not reach for 2 days. He went home because there's a project of the house of my sister, and it is my father who takes care of all of the construction there. Then, when it came on that first Saturday that we had, we are all complete with my brothers and sisters. We started sharing the word. We started to talk about the life, the natural life that we had, and what about the spiritual things, which is very important. While my brother-in-law bought a wine, because I have two brothers there, while they started to drink and offered me, I told them, I'm not drinking. Then my sister said, teased her husband, that I will gamble with you if you will let my brother to drink a wine, I will gamble for you. But I just told him that simply that I'm not drinking at all, and, because we know that we are the temple of the Lord. But we're sharing the word of the Lord during the time. They have a questions. My sister-in-law, even my sister-in-law, which is my classmate on my high school and elementary, they have questions. And even my sister itself, they have questions raised. And even though on that navigation, I'm happy because on the following Sunday, my sister-in-law, I can see in her heart that there's something that she had been sincere when it comes to the Lord. And on the following Sunday, she decided to attend service. And even though that I have, even when I came back here in the short vacation, I have trials again. Even after a couple of days, my brother got an accident. The brother, which is third from me, and I always pray for the Lord that for all of their salvation. And it is how many times that my brother got an accident, but the Lord still preserved his life.
Amen.
And I thank the Lord that he got only a big wound in the right leg. He has no any fracture. And that's the opportunity again. I didn't look for it as a negative thing, but I'm happy in my heart, because it is the time that it is always reminding them to go back to the Lord. We're not looking about this vessel of flesh, but we're looking about the soul.
Amen.
And the thing is that my mom decided to go in our province in Pangasinan, because my brother, which is got an accident, she will look for it. And also, she decided, and I thank the Lord that she had the design in my mom's heart, that to go in the church to invite all my brothers and my sister-in-law to go to church. And I'm happy because I had the chance to share the word of the Lord. Even my sister, next after me, she got a lot of questions. And I know that I'm applying the token. But the message said that you have to apply the token for your loved ones. Whatever the situation that they have right now, in the message, desperation, those that you are expecting are not there. But those that you're not expecting will be there. And before coming back here on vacation, actually we got some obstacle traveling back here, expecting that supposedly we'll be here on the 25th, as what I booked, what we have in our mindset, because 24th it is Sunday, and 25th I'm expecting to be here on the 25th. But I didn't told anybody what happened in our flight going back here. Actually, what we're expecting, since I'm booking Cebu Pacific and Qatar Airways, mindset that I will be here on the 25th. But so we have the last service that we have there in the church in Santa Maria. And when we went to the airport, and actually all is said already, we are already in the counter. When the Qatar Airways staff checked our ticket, she just looked at me so worried. He said that, "Sir, your flight was yesterday." So sometimes, you know, sometimes things happen in our life that we cannot understand, we cannot explain. And then my wife is blaming and told me that that's the thing, because you're rushing in your decision. But you know, every time that I'm deciding, I'm always consult to the Lord, pray to the Lord. That if it is not your will, let it be. It will have an obstacle. But whatever is the will, Lord, I'm always praying every single thing. Whatever is the will to be done. Then you know, oh come on, when I was there in front of that counter, I just said, oh come on, what happened? It's 24th, and we were in the airport Monday, it's 25th. We thought that what we booked is 25th. What we also, I think in Cebu Pacific, what I remember, it is 25th. So I told them, I'm expecting again. But I did not murmur, I just commit to the Lord. Whatever is the will, Lord, so be it. So the Qatar Airways staff just told us that just go to the Qatar Airways office behind the door, and we went there and we talked to the Qatar Airways staff there in that office that about the case. And she said that, "Sir, I told him all the possibilities," and she said that, "Sir, since it is no appearance, so we cannot do anything." And then we checked the booking. He said, "There's a booking tomorrow, but the amount is this one. There's a booking after tomorrow, but the amount is this one." We know already how very expensive, especially that is the peak season and it is very urgent schedule. Then I told her that, but then she went to the, then the Qatar Airways staff went to the, I think to the staff, she confirmed to the supervisor. Then when nobody was there in the office, I told to my wife, my family, that we have to pray to the Lord. And then we pray earnestly to the Lord, and I pray to the Lord, that just show that you are the God that you are serving. Show your power. I thank the Lord that I have no doubt in my heart, even the very big circumstances that we have. Show your power once again. Then after that, Qatar Airways came back again, and she said, confirm all of the schedule. And I told that, okay, just book for us after tomorrow. And then all the savings that I kept in my account for the enrollment of my son, it was all drained. I told my wife that I will spend all this for our ticket, and you will be the one spending for the hotel and the food that we have. Then so we stayed, and we decided to stay in the hotel, in the airport, since tomorrow the following day will be our schedule on the following day. And we went in the hotel, we just stayed there and rest. And then on the following morning, we prayed again to the Lord before leaving. And we prayed to the Lord, and we were already on the counter on the following morning, when we were in the counter, my heart still have a peace. I didn't bother whatever things happened. Because our God, He has a purpose, I'm always telling you. I told to my wife when we were, before we prayed in the Qatar's office, that, you know, God has a purpose. Don't complain or murmur. God has a purpose. We believe that all things work together for good. We are serving a living God that created the whole universe. So how much more in the small things that we have in our life? You know, the following morning, all my money in my account that for the enrollment of my son that I can pay for a cash, it was drained. And then I'm thinking that I had to use my credit card, but I just kept in my heart that I want to use my credit card. Then when we were on the following morning, we were in the counter again for before the flight. Then the supervisor approached us when we were in the counter. I just have the peace in my heart and I just commit to the Lord. I have faith in my heart that the Lord is our Jehovah Jireh. Amen. He will provide for us a sacrifice and everything that we need. And then when we went to the counter, then the Qatar Airways supervisor approached me. Then she said that, sir, if you don't mind, are you rushing to go back in Doha? I told her that, no, actually, I'm not rushing since my work is on the next Sunday. I still have a couple of days. Then she said that, I will just give you an offer. If you would like to stay here tomorrow, so I stay here for one day and tomorrow your schedule will be fixed tomorrow. Then we will offer you this amount for each ticket and hotel for this. Then I was so glad that God is answering already.
Yeah.
Then it is more than 150 riyals per ticket. It's where three. And we have a free hotel in Radisson Blu at the back of SM Fairview. And then I thought to my wife, and then of course my son is happy again, my wife, because it is second day that we'll be having hotel again. Then I'm teasing my wife that, you know, if the supervisor will ask us again tomorrow, we will be again in the first. By the way, we're not in a hurry. So that's the reason that we didn't came here on the 25th and 26th. And, you know, all the things that was drained to us, it was returned back by the Lord.
Amen.
Whatever that we need, it was returned back by the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And on that moment, I remember that Job, in the midst of his trials and all the distress,
Amen,
troubles that he had, when we read the last chapter of the book of Job, you know, God gave him the blessings double for the natural things. But for his loved ones, it is what he had before that was lost, it is the same number that God has been returned back to him. And you know, all the prophet said in the message, whatever Job has, the loved ones that he had, God has been given back to him. It was with him in that other set of life. And that's why, you know, my brothers and sisters, don't worry. If you have the loved ones, that's still not in the message. God has a promise to us.
Amen.
You have to apply the appointment. And sorry that it takes a long time, but
no,
all the praise and all the glory belong to our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
We love Him. We love Him. Amen. 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 Amen.
Sino pa pong gusto mong magpatuto?
Lari na po kami ng sister Angie at nagpapasalamat po ako sa bagay na nangyari sa buong isang linggo. Sister Angie.
make you stay. But it's okay, what's ahead? It's Holy Spirit. I know this world will reject me. My friends will despise me. But that's okay. That's okay. I'm not here for this purpose. Is for the purpose of Him to be found in me. When He returns the day, so I cry now for Your Holy Spirit. It makes no sense for my existence without it. I'm crying now.
$6,367 at Ariel sa ating mundo. At itong ating sa cash receive natin mula sa love offering, sa pledges, at sa mission fund box, we have gathered 4,423. At sa ating cash spend, mula sa weekly food expenses, sa groceries and miscellaneous items, sa rentals, at meron tayong 4,028. Sa ating total cash flow, sa cash received minus the less the cash spent is 395. So the outstanding balance as of Friday, March 25, 2016, we have 6,762 Qatari riyals. Amen. At sa buwan ng April 2016, ang ating cash balance beginning of April 2016, we have 6,762. At mula sa love offering, sa pledges, sa mission fund, at sa refund from shared rentals, we have gathered 5,742 Qatari riyals. Sa ating cash spend, nagmula sa weekly food expenses, sa ating rentals, sa mission fund, we have 5,229. So, total cash flow sa cash received, less the cash spend, we have 513 riyals. So, ating outstanding balance as of Friday, April 29, 2016, we have gathered 7,275.
Salamat po, Panginoon, muli sa araw na ito. Nabigyan mo kami ng pagkakataon. pagkakataon na muli mo kita-kita at magpuri sa inyo. Mga pastor, sa inyo na ito, kasama niyo kami. Panginoon, ang pera ng aming pinitulong ng Panginoon, hinihinga namin ang basta sa inyo, Panginoon. Kaya mo magkapapalang pa kayo na magamit ito sa tama, Panginoon. Alam po namin, Panginoon, na hindi ko kailangan sa labing ito. Yes, alam po namin na ang bawat isa ay binibigay nila ang punong dedikasyon, Panginoon, na kampanan kung bakit kami nalagay ito. Ito po matulungan ang bawat ipati. Pagpagamit ito sa pamamaraan at bigay ng mensahe, Panginoon. Panginoon, bigyan kami ng mga puso na pagbibigay ng bukas sa amin, Panginoon. Pagbibigay na hindi hihingi ng anumang kapalit na biyaya sa magkagaya. Pagbibigay kami dahil ito'y gusto namin. Ito'y nais namin. Pagbibigay kami dahil alam namin ito'y nagagamit ng tama, Panginoon. Panginoon, pinasasalamatan namin ang mga bawat isang kapatid na tumutulong sa mga gawain ito, sa mga naghahanda ng pagkain ng mga kapatid.
Amen, Lord!
Alam namin na kayo ang great provider, Panginoon.
Yes.
Ano man ang ibigay ng bawat isa sa amin, Panginoon, ay kaya mong ibigalik ng doble-doble.
Yes, yes.
Panginoon, ang lahat na ito ay pasasalamat namin sa inyo. At ang tanging hinihiling namin sa inyo, Panginoon, ay huwag mo kaming iiwan, huwag mo kaming bibitawan, at kaya mo kami makapasok, Panginoon, sa inyo.
Yes, yes.
Panginoon, maraming salamat. Maraming salamat sa biyaya. Maraming salamat sa paggabay, Panginoon. Ang lahat po ng papuri at salamat namin ay inaalay namin sa inyo lamang.
Amen.
Maraming salamat.
Amen.
Amen.
guides you, no? Praise God. Pagkabihin yung kasabi na kay Kailan mo yun. Wala na pala kaya na isang tao, kaya wala rin. Dito po kayo, Panginoon. May pinagawa sa harap ng inyo, Lord. Taong sinawag ninyo. Pagkabihin yung grace and mercy.
Praise God.
Akin na nagkaroon yung sinasabi. Hindi ko po alam, ha? Kailangan sa atas, Espiritu, yung Panginoon, kung hindi niyo po ang tutulungan. Palmer will have left, and the locust eaten. That which the locust had left, and the caterpillar will have eaten. That which the caterpillar will have left, and the caterpillar eaten. And in Romans chapter 1, verse 24. Therefore God also gave them up to uncleanness, to the lust of their own hearts, to dishonor their own bodies between themselves. Change the truth of God into a lie, and worship and serve the creature more than the creator who is blessed forever. Romans 3:4, let God be true. Let the Bible be true. Every words. Therefore greet ye, let God be true. Every man a liar and truth in them. That thou mightest be justified, they say you should have so much time in the world. Is the worship of the Lord? Amen. 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 The title of our message is Underworm, Locus, Underworm, Caterpillar. Puruhod, no? Hallelujah. Kakatuloy prophet natin. May marami this message to the prophet. When you take it literally, you will find only a fruit that is eaten by their work. But there is a spiritual meaning to this. Our church is nicer now than before. You see our church. We are in Salata. It's not called a church. There is more room now. It's beautiful. It's going to give us a new church. See? Nowadays, they are more or less propagating good churches, beautiful churches, beautiful choir, beautiful musicians, beautiful music, beautiful programs. I'm not against that. But the thing is, they don't mind the word.
That's true. Right. That's right.
Hallelujah. They don't mind the word already.
That's true.
Here, in this church, we don't care for the attraction of the eyes. We care for the attraction of the word. Because you know why? Because the word is life to you.
Amen.
Here we don't preach any doctrine. Let's say we preach Baptist doctrines, the Methodist would not agree. We preach Methodist at the Church of Christ would not agree. We preach Church of Christ doctrine, the Pentecostal would not agree. So we don't preach. We don't preach churchianal doctrine. We preach the truth from the Word of God.
Hallelujah.
See, denominational ideas produce division.
That's true.
That's why the Pentecostal cannot fellowship with the Baptist. The Baptist cannot fellowship with the Nazarene. Catholic also cannot preach. Cannot fellowship with the born again. Hallelujah. They bring division. What we preach is being given to us by direct revelation from God.
Amen.
What we preach is being given to us by direct revelation from the Holy Spirit. That's why when you bring this message to this denomination, they will drop you out.
Right.
They will drop you out and you cannot come back.
That's
or they will not say anything. Why? Because they think they are right in their own belief. They think they are correct.
That's true.
That's why the Bible says, let God be true and God must well be a lie.
Amen.
Hallelujah. See, but now there is a message that you can be restored back to the original. See, now you should think seriously why you need restoration.
That's right.
Think it seriously.
Hallelujah.
Don't take this message lightly. Think it seriously. See, to bring back restoration means bring back to its original state.
Amen.
To bring back to its original state.
Amen.
Something went wrong somewhere.
That's right.
Something went wrong somewhere.
Amen.
Hallelujah. See, the only thing it will work if it is in the law of that thing. Hallelujah. Planets can be moved by the law of the planets.
Yes.
The earth revolves around the sun by the law of the sun and the earth itself. God designed it according to His will. Hallelujah. According to the plan of God.
Amen.
See, so it should go that way and operate that way, God's way, not any other way if man wanted.
That's right.
What about the Bible? Hallelujah.
Amen.
They say you are having a bicycle. You know, sprocket and the chain.
Yes.
If that sprocket and the chain don't go together, you cannot make the bicycle.
That's right.
Move quite smoothly.
That's right.
The sprocket and the chain should be fixed properly to move that bicycle according to its movement. So that's what the Bible is. All the scriptures should tie together.
Amen.
You cannot reject one scripture except another scripture.
That's true. Amen.
You should dovetail all the scriptures together.
Amen.
There is nothing wrong with our Bible.
That's right.
Listen, there is nothing wrong with our Bible.
Correct.
You say there's something wrong with the Bible? The wrong thing is the mind of the people.
Yes, right.
Yes.
Amen.
Hallelujah. See, that's what's happening to this born again Trinitarian and born again so forth. There is prophet in the changes. This is not big together.
Oh my.
Hallelujah. So if you heard something that you don't understand, listen. If you heard something that you don't understand, especially with the Word of God, sit down and study.
Don't
reason out.
That's right.
Right? So if you don't understand, especially in the message, sit down and study. Ask questions.
Yes, right.
Hallelujah. There is something wrong, there is a cause.
Yes. That's right.
Kaya kaganyan-ganyan ang human being.
That's right.
They ever talk differently. That's why when the Word of God comes to them, diyan ang turo sa amin. Nakalibot na. Bumay. If the teaching of the churches is correct, all correct, God will not destroy this earth.
That's right.
That's right.
Why will you destroy this earth? Why? Because, listen, if you don't teach the word according to its plan, according to the redemption plan of the Lord, it will not do good to the people.
That's right.
It will not do any good to you. Even how much you shout, no. You must go according to the plan of God, or else the Word of God will not have no effect on you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Kaya ang tao pagkaturuan mo ng wa-effect na salita, wa-effect yung Word sa kanya. When the Word of God comes to him, wa-effect. Hindi ka papasinin. So you need a strong hand, a strong preaching to shake the unbelief in the people. See? If a doctor, you go to his office, I'm having headache, sickness in my stomach, I give you aspirin, the doctor just want to get rid of you.
Yes,
go for aspirin, but sakit sa ulo, sakit sa tiyan, sakit sa papa na doon. Isa lang. Ibigay niyang his customer. See, but a good doctor will diagnose the case,
yes.
Find out what organ is out of control,
of course, yes.
Then work from that organ,
yes.
And causing the sickness. That's in it with the kingdom of God. Find out what is wrong.
Mm-hmm. Yes,
hallelujah.
and work from that. See, and give the doctor's prescription. Hallelujah. And the doctor is giving prescription, he should be careful in what's giving.
That's right.
Because if he gives the wrong prescription, he might kill the patient.
That's right.
Hallelujah. That's why in these churches, now, outside of this message, is dead spiritually.
Amen.
Why? They don't have a specialist to train them, to give them prescription. That is not a doctor. It's called quack doctor.
Why?
It's called the quack minister.
Yeah.
Not everybody is standing in the pulpit.
That's right, that's right.
There is quack minister.
Yes.
So be careful in what you're hearing.
Your money.
Because if you're hearing quack minister, you'll become a quack believer.
Correct.
You are.
Amen.
Remember.
That's right.
The Bible says that tell us, do not add or take away from the Scripture.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Why? The Scripture is enough.
Amen.
You don't need your private interpretation. You don't need help. God don't need your help. Just say it as what it is.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
That's what it is.
See, that Scripture is enough to kill your disease.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
Meron ka sakit. A believer ka. Yes. A believer to the Word of God is a spiritual sickness.
Yes. Yes. That's right.
Hallelujah. See, the only thing, listen to this, you need restoration is for you to go back to your original.
Mm-hmm.
Go back to your original state.
Amen.
See?
Yes.
The only thing it will work if it is in the law of that thing.
Mm-hmm.
The uh-huh. only thing if law.
Yes, 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 yes.
The only thing, Brother Reyes experienced this. Brother see Brother Henry's experience of this. You have experience of this, Sister Jerry. The gospel did not fall on you, but because that is not the law of God, that is
yes,
the law of man, that is
man-made
idea. So that law of God should be applied unto you.
Amen.
It will work.
Hallelujah.
Cosmic forces can move only to cosmic law.
Correct.
Planets can be moved only to the planets. So it's according to the law of God. Operate according to God's law. No other way that man can cover it.
Yes.
See. Well, you may say they're sincere. It's like the Marbury. Like, they're very sincere. Hallelujah.
Lord God has.
More than us.
Yes.
Because they, according to them, we attended one Bible study. They say they are resting only Saturday.
Mm-hmm.
So, but full week, concentrated, missions, Bible studies, go somewhere else. Time of Friday now. But for them, they are busy the rest of the week.
Oh,
sincerely,
strong.
That's
true, man.
You see how accurate is this Bible?
Oh my
God. That's why God put to it that you should go on into the message of the hour.
Amen.
So your faith should be correct.
That's right.
God will not honor wrong things.
Yes.
Because He's a God of perfection.
Amen.
Hallelujah. See. That's why He told in Joel 1:3. Listen to this. Tell your children. And let your children tell their children.
Mm-hmm.
Let the children, mistreat children. Si Nicole, pag lumaki, tell di ba magiging son ni Nicole?
Yes.
This is all like this.
Yes, right.
What God said in the Bible, tell it to your generation. Say it, they will not depart from it.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes, amen.
See? So it's true until now.
Amen. Right.
Hallelujah. But did they hear what God said? No, they put their own idea interpretation to the Word of God. That's what the palmer worm was left, is the caterpillar eaten, caterpillar locust and so forth. Always see the same insect. It's only in its different stage of life. A cocoon is a caterpillar covered, then become butterfly, you know that, right? So this insect is just going, locust, same.
Whatever it caused in the beginning, it's still the same until now. It's the same insect.
Hallelujah.
That's right.
Let's go back and find out how it started.
Hallelujah.
We got to have material to base our belief. That's all we have. Now, find out what did he eat. Now Jesus said, he's the vine and we are the branches, right? Now the bark is the lifeline of the tree. Take out the bark and you kill the tree.
That's right.
Naturally.
That's right.
And the Bible is in the life, lifeline to any church. The Bible is in the lifeline to any church.
Amen.
Now, if the bark is out of you, you got to put the same bark and you cannot do it because only God can do
yes,
it.
Yes, yes. Yes, amen.
The only thing that you can grow back the bark is only God instead of the wind. No
that's
man
right.
can do it.
That's
hallelujah.
Right.
That's why they don't have the fruits.
That's right.
Hallelujah. Nowadays, no fruit of knowledge, no fruit of patience, godliness, long suffering, gentleness, godliness. Why the lifeline is cut off? Wrap it with man-made ideas.
Amen.
Hallelujah. But they cannot see it. They cannot see it that they are wrong. They think they are right. Hallelujah. They can read, but they cannot see it.
That's right.
They have ears, but they cannot hear it.
Amen.
Salamat kayo, meron kayo tenga, meron kayo mata.
Amen.
Understand. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It's not revealed to them. The Bible is filled with the spiritual revelation of His Word. So is His church. Hallelujah. That's why, listen, he accepted Abel and his offering.
Right.
He did not accept Cain and his offering.
Yes,
because
amen.
There is no spiritual revelation in the offering of beautiful flowers, beautiful churches.
That's right.
But there's no spiritual revelation. The very first offering that man made, God refused.
That's right. That's right. That's right.
It's the same too today.
Yes, that's right.
They're beautifying the churches, they're beautifying the choir, never mind the word.
Oh my.
Hallelujah. But Abel, he said, you read the book of Genesis, see if somebody taught Abel how to offer.
Mm-hmm.
Nobody teaches Abel how to offer. How we know?
It's revelation.
How we know that God like animal blood?
According
to Hebrews 11:4, by faith Abel offered unto God a more excellent.
Amen.
So, excellent. Offering ni Cain, excellent ka?
Yes, amen.
I hope you get me this.
Yeah.
The offering of Cain is excellent, but God requires more excellence.
Amen.
Amen.
That's why these churches, they worship. Ganda. Ganda, di ba Brad?
Yes.
Excellent na. Pero, meron pang mas excellent.
Amen.
It's the word. It's the revelation of the word of the hour. It's the more excellent sacrifice.
That's right.
Amen. Hallelujah. See, but God gave him a chance.
Amen.
He got angry. Instead of imitating what his brother is doing, well, you know, mo karinya tinanggap ng Panginoon, dapat hindi gagayahin ko rin. Diba? That's supposed to be the case. Gagayahin ko rin, ganun pala gusto ni Lord. Pero hindi. Sino siya? Nagalit siya? Sabi ni Lord, ba't ka nagagalit? Kung gumawa ka na mabuti, tatanggapin na rin.
Yes.
Amen.
Boom.
Hallelujah. Di ba ganun ngayon ng sitwasyon pag you brought up the message there, you get angry. Nung una, brother, welcome. Lalayasan ka na.
That's true.
It's happening.
Yes.
You know the effort of bringing to them the word? Patiently we go there, but it's far away. We share the word, me and Brother Dundee. Walang effect. Hallelujah. Bakit walang effect?
It's mostly
no good ground.
Kaya niya na.
Amen.
There is too much fight to be answered. Why? Why Cain, he see the offering that is accepted by God, why he did not do the same? That is why. Why? When God tell him, if you do the same, you will be accepted. Still angry.
Oh,
in front of the Almighty God. Why?
Yes.
There is too much why that you should know why. Why? Hallelujah. Because Cain is not a seed of God.
Listen to this.
Satan came from heaven. He worshiped God there. Right?
Yes, he has a father.
Yes, he came down to the earth. And he has sons and daughter.
Amen. That's right. That's true. That's
right. With worship God without revelation.
Yes, right.
Hallelujah. See? Hallelujah. Why are you staying here in this message? You are pure. Hallelujah. Why you cannot go to other place?
No.
Why? There is a reason.
Yes.
Alright. Yes. There is a cause, there is a reason.
Yes.
Because there is something in you.
Amen.
That may not be other.
That's right.
Amen. Try it.
Amen.
Go to other churches. Try it. You cannot. Well, my mother, if she was here 2 years ago, Sister Ning met him at
Joan.
You will come up next Friday. He said, I attended this church. He said, nothing to me. See, after 2 years, still God is holding his heart.
Hallelujah.
You are born an eagle, you are an eagle to begin with.
Yes. Yes.
Thank the Lord.
See. There is no flower rewards here.
No.
No flower rewards in this message. Walang bola-bola dito. Walang bola-bola, bibilugin ang ulo mo para bumalik-balikan. No. Hallelujah. See, do you know Pharisees? Pharisees, Brother Branham said you cannot put your finger on their life.
Correct.
See, they are as good people as can be. Hallelujah. But they are blind to see Jesus Christ.
That's true.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Look at Esau and Jacob. Look at Pharaoh's heart. Pharaoh.
Right.
The Bible says, God hardens Pharaoh's heart.
That's right.
Kung hindi inarden ng Diyos yung puso ni Pharaoh, bumalik na si bibigyan ako.
No. Yes.
But you are hardened the heart of Pharaoh. Listen to this. If you hear this message, and you harden your heart, God will harden you.
That's true.
You will never be soft again.
Amen.
Let God be true, everyone alive. Let's line up ourselves, our faith, into the Word of God.
Amen.
Because if any man say, the Bible say, he that knoweth to do good and do it not, to him is sin.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
Kahit gano'ng ka-ridiculous, hindi kahit gano'ng hindi mo maintindihan, simula tanggapin mo.
That's right.
Yes.
Maintindihan mo rin yan in the long place.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Now let's go back to the original church, the day of Pentecost. So if God is infinite, listen, His church must be the same from the very beginning.
Yes, that's right.
Hallelujah. Yes, wala dapat mga isip-isip.
Yes, that's right.
Hallelujah. But man has touched it. Hallelujah. Do you know? You know, Lutheranus was correct in their time?
Right. Yes,
what happened to Luther? Time?
Yes, right.
It's correct in their time.
Right.
You read the same Bible as we are reading?
Yes, exactly.
In Wesley's time, God's message is correct. In Wesley's
yes,
time.
In their time.
In their time.
I have a good example.
Yes.
In the Pentecostal area,
yes.
Age, God's message is correct in that time.
In their time.
Right.
Why this message? Listen to this. Why this message is not given to Luther?
Oh my,
that's big.
Why? Why this message, the bright message, is not given to Luther?
Not for them.
Because that is the type of reformation that is.
See? Kasi, they came from the Dark Ages.
Yes.
They came from the Dark Ages. So when you erect, when you give this message to them, magbubulo na sila.
That's right.
Magbubulo na, they cannot able to take it. So God started with justification.
That's right.
So you forget that you're
erect.
See, but they But they got justification. They closed their door for justification. Come another message with the sanctification.
Right.
And Wesley is true to his message to that time.
Yes, yes.
But after that time, yung mga believer na naiwan, nag-organize. Okay, Methodist.
Oh,
my. Yung Panginoon.
Oh, my.
Then go to the Pentecostal. They began to speak in tongues. Entertain the gift of the Spirit. They begin to organize. Mm. And then can really.
Wala na naman ah.
Kasi pumunta.
Wala na naman. It's outside.
Ma, pabukod na message.
Wala siya dito. Siya makatap siya dito.
Yes.
Wala siya. Right.
No more. Hallelujah.
Invisible. And that's why you're eating the invisible union.
Amen.
Kaya pag-unite ka sa Panginoon, by saying amen to the Word of God. Hallelujah. By saying amen to the Bible, with the Revelation. Come back to the original.
Yes, amen.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
See. Put their own interpretation and don't turn. The Bible says, don't try to interpret it by yourself.
Yes.
If you got the Holy Ghost, interpret it according to what the interpretation
says. Right,
but don't interpret it yourself. Hallelujah. Yes,
that's right.
By the way, I'm sorry for joking. Talagang ako'y masiyahin tao. But the pulpit is no place for joking.
Yes, that's true.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Something went out from the church, the camp. Conquer world, eat the life of truth, let the life of faith. Now, faith is substituted with catechism.
Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah. Big denomination, turn to Jude 1:3. Beloved. Beloved, when I gave all diligence to write unto you of the common salvation, see, it's common. It was needful for me to write to you and exhort you that you should earnestly contend for the faith which was once delivered by the saints. You stay with the faith that was delivered to the saints and you're saved. Hallelujah. See. This is Jude said this before. Now we have 2,000 years. What about now?
Right.
What happened to the faith? Hallelujah. Yeah. Now when you told them the truth, they say, let us engage by faith. Hindi ganyan tinuro sa amin ng church. Hallelujah. The Bible say there is one faith, one Lord,
one
baptism. Now there are too much kinds of baptism, there are too much kinds of Lord, there are too much kinds of faith. Hallelujah. The Bible say, be content with the faith of the saints.
Amen.
Now we have the faith of the saints. Go back to the original.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Why you need to be contented with the faith once delivered to the saints? Because the saints are sanctified people.
Yes, amen.
The saints is with the, if you become a saint of God, you have the Holy Ghost in you.
That's right.
That sanctifies you.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Be content.
Yes.
Be content of that. Be content of the Holy Ghost that's in you.
Amen.
I stand for the faith that was once delivered to the saints. Not in the creed, not in denomination, not in buildings, not in association, assemblies, not in the pastors and ministers,
amen.
But in the presence of the living God.
That's right.
Hallelujah. Cast out devils, make miracles, signs and wonders, hold on to God's promises, live a Christian life. That was a faith. They hold on to that. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The faith that was once delivered to the saints is a lifeline of the church.
Yes, amen.
Hallelujah. Hold to that. After that, until death shall set in you, shall set us free, don't compromise, don't believe, preach. What anybody say? If somebody say to you, not in the Bible, throw it.
That's right.
That's the way to stand, to contend with the faith that was delivered to the saint. Here we don't have creed but Christ. We don't have no law but love.
Amen.
No book but the Bible.
Amen.
It must be back and forth. from Genesis to Revelation.
Amen.
Hallelujah. That's what Jesus Christ, he weaves himself into the Word. He is the Word himself.
Yes, amen.
If God is perfect, you can't say something here and contradict him.
No.
The Bible is not like that. The Bible is so written that it is in harmony.
Yes.
It should dovetail to one another.
That's right.
Hallelujah. But it's written like that.
Amen.
When you read, it seems confusing.
No.
But it's written like that, confuse the wise and the prudent and reveal it to babes.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Why did he ever let sin come in for him to become a savior?
Yes.
Because if there is now something lost, he won't save anything. Hallelujah. Why did he let a man get sick for a purpose of being become a healer?
Yes.
Dahil kung wala ka sakit, wala siyang gagawin.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Ano nga yung mga medicine, hindi yan ang tunayang gawin?
No.
This aid. But who can restore back the cells? It's God. Hallelujah. Can you say the day of miracle is past?
No.
Then you are not contending for the
that's right.
For the faith that must deliver to the saints. Hallelujah. The Bible says Jesus Christ the same yesterday, today,
forever.
Amen to that.
Amen.
If you say that was for the apostle, don't say amen to that.
That's right.
God gave fivefold ministry. So correct. In the fivefold ministry, God will operate to the apostle, he will operate to the teacher.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Don't say, my pastor said like this. Pag yung sinabi nyo, hindi ko sinabi, hindi ko aminin yan.
That's right.
Kung may sabi yan, ikaw lang. See. Now, that old caterpillar will say same thing. Not like this, not like that, not like this, not like that. Hallelujah. Madami may ministrong uuti.
Hallelujah.
Alam nyo ba kayong mauuti kayo?
Yes.
Alam nyo mauuti kayo? Job 25 verses. Oh. How much less man that is a worm and the son of mapaking prophet? Brother Manu, uuti pa rin.
That's right.
Right?
Right.
Pero tayo, we are a very special class of
people. Yes. Yes.
I like that. Hindi tayo nakapag, hindi tayo mabubos ng dahon, hindi tayo mabubos ng bar. We rely on the roots because that's the lifeline of the faith. That's the line, the roots. Hindi niya nakain, nakain niya yung mga dahon.
Yes, bark.
He eat the bark, he eat the leaves, he eat the fruits, at hindi niya nakain yung roots.
Yes.
Amen. Hallelujah. Ang mga bride of Jesus Christ kumakain ng roots pero hindi para mamatay.
No.
Para ma-sustain yung life of the world.
Amen.
Hallelujah. See? Those minister bugs. Right?
That's right.
Brother Branham is saying, if ever God put out the branch, it will be of the original tree. See, oh yes, you cannot take grapes from pumpkin, whatever life in the vine, it will produce itself on it. So if you have Jesus Christ in you, it will produce the life of Christ in you.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. See, maring not abruptly, maring slowly, maring lifetime, but it will produce the life of Christ in you.
Yes, right.
Whatever you are. 10 years ago, from the message, you are not the same person this time.
Yes, amen. That's true.
I'm sure. You are reborn again with the Spirit.
That's true.
Your life has changed from what you are to what you are now. Hallelujah. Father Bo, I testify. Father Ring, I testify. Father Henry, I testify. Every one of you who is in the message can testify. I am not ashamed.
Hallelujah.
First, the Bible says, believe mo.
Amen.
See, alam mo, you're just a shell. Shell ka lang.
Yes.
Much like a water pipe. He is not the water. He's just the pipe.
Correct.
Kaluyan lang siya. What happened? If the water is stagnant, nakalawangin yung pipe.
Yes.
So you let the life of The water of the word flows in you.
Amen.
Para hindi ka kalawangin.
Correct.
Hallelujah. Ang gusto ko lang dito sa message, when God promised, hindi ka niya iwan.
Amen. Amen. That's right. That's right.
Amen. Amen.
That's right.
Hanapin mo siya.
Amen.
Ibig mo na
umalis, ayaw. Ayaw.
Hatangin kanya babalik. Amen. Diyos na sinasamba natin.
Amen.
Hindi trial and error. Hallelujah. Next, Eden is the brotherly love. Paul said, let brotherly love continue. But now, it is taken away. Listen, if your pastor or teacher does not teach you the truth, he don't love you.
That's true.
Ibig lang niya pera niyo.
That's true.
If he don't teach you the truth, hindi ka nasasaktan sa mga sinasabi niya.
Yeah.
Listen, kung hindi ka nasasaktan, wala masasaktan sa'yo. Again, if there's, kung wala ka, mayroon sa English eh.
If
wala nasasaktan sa'yo, wala kang dapat isakit. Wala dapat masakit. Sige, sinabi kong, ikaw, sigarilyo ka ng sigarilyo.
Hindi mo
ginagawa. Hindi ka masasaktan.
That's right. Anong meron?
Di ba?
That's right.
Eh kung sabihin ko na, diyan sa bag mo, may mga makeup, may mga, may sasaktan ka pag meron.
Meron.
Tulad nung siya pumasok sa church ni Brother Branham, tago siya ng sigarilyo eh. Sabi ni Brother Branham, bedeli pa mo. Kung titigil mo yan, nilagay mo dyan sa busa mo. Alam ng Diyos yan.
Amen.
Mga tinatagong mga sekreto. Mga chine-cherish na kasalanan. Tapon nyo na yan. Tapon nyo na lahat yung mga bagay na gumugulo. Alam nyo mali, tapon nyo. Kung hindi nyo makaya, pray to God.
Amen.
Pray to God.
Yes,
hallelujah. Okay, ito mga brother. You will see, brother, did you lose your interest in cigarette?
Hallelujah.
You just lose your interest in cigarette. You have to last sa akin yung cigarette nyo. Because God remove it. Ano ba naman yung paninigan ninyo?
Yeah.
Ang dali lang, demonyo yun eh.
That's true.
Demonyo na paninigarin. Demonyo pag inom. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Yung ikaw lang. Yung ikaw, jablo yan eh.
That's true.
Kamo, pag ikaw siya, nagduguin tayo niya. Kaya yun ang Diyos na may garnish ka. Pag naging na-rapture, masasabi ka. Masasabi ka doon sa... Kailangan pag na-rapture ka na pala, God will rapture you. There is no garnish.
Yes.
You come like that, you go like that.
Yes.
Hallelujah. See, if you put a substitute in the bark, because the bark is the lifeline, and wrap it with the bag, it won't send the sap of the tree, it will not bear fruit. Just the same as Christian now.
Yes.
There is a wrap around Christianity of preach and ideas. The lifeline will not continue on track, it will drop down to the ground. That's the reason of dead Christian. Hallelujah. See? The brotherly love is cut off with denominational counter world.
Amen.
When minister cut it off, what happened? The branches will not bear fruits.
That's right.
Hallelujah.
That's right.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Come on, don't die. The thing is, people don't like. Mm-hmm. They like compromising word. Hallelujah. A good healthy tree. A good healthy tree. Don't have to be sprayed.
Mm-hmm.
Why? We are spraying over and over because that tree is not healthy.
That's
right. Spraying is because it's not healthy. Why Christian denomination has eaten the life out of it? Absolutely. Methodist, Baptist, Adventist, Trinitarianism, Onesim, Pentecostalism. They all eat the line out of the tree, substituting denominational teaching.
That's true.
To bring all men under politics and preach. After 300 years of the death of the last apostles, they formed the spare organization which is the Catholic Church in 325 AD, they started the doctrine of Trinitarianism, which is spread all over the world.
Amen.
325 AD. Now the truth is buried already.
Yes.
Only right. This church knows the doctrine of Amen. Jesus Christ.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Only this church. Hallelujah. Revelation 17 says, he's the mother of the harlots. Hindi naman ako Katoliko.
Hallelujah.
Eh, anak ka naman ang Katoliko. Ganun ka rin. Hallelujah. Now they hold to the denominational ranks instead of the word. Hallelujah.
It's true.
And denomination, what is the meaning of denomination? They pens around you.
That's right.
So their doctrines and ideas. Right. You put pens. I'm a Baptist. I'm a Methodist. I'm a Catholic.
Right.
Hindi ka makakalabas doon.
Correct.
Hallelujah. Do you know what they do to their martyrs? They throw them to lions. They would burn stakes. See, these believers before, they are willing to die for the word.
Amen.
They don't care for their lives.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Now our persecution is not physical. Listen to this. Magtataka ka. You will wonder, why are you willing to die for the word? Because that's the spirit that was given in that age. The spirit of Acts.
That's right.
They are willing to die for the word.
Yes.
Now, the spirit that was given in this age is so high, martyrdom is not anymore, but you will be persecuted spiritually.
Yes, amen.
Hallelujah. Ang mga kalaban mo na, hindi na yung pamilya mo. Dati pamilya. Before families goes to the lion, ngayon ang kalaban mo, pamilya mo na.
Yun na yun.
Ha? Alam mo yung nanay mo.
That's right.
But praise God. Praise God for it. Yeah. Ito, nangyayari sa akin yung
scripture.
Yes, amen. Sabihin, anak, anak na ng Diyos.
Amen.
Say amen to that.
Amen.
Sabihin, anak ka na ng Diyos.
Amen.
Marami sa yung scripture.
Yes, amen.
Hallelujah. It is made possible by the new word.
Yes.
Otherwise, sasama ka na lang yung sasama sa magulang mo. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
See? Now there is a showdown. Trinitarianism. There is one God or there is three gods?
Mm-hmm.
There was only one God. Kasi natin na nakakalimutan mo na naman eh.
Go.
Let's go back to Isaiah 43. Remember, the Bible is no contradiction.
Amen.
If there is contradiction in the Bible, God is contradicting Himself.
Yes.
If there is contradiction in the Bible after the service, tell me. If there is, I will answer. Don't get time for it. You are my witnesses, said the Lord. And my Isaiah 43 said the Old Testament. And my servant whom I have chosen, that you may know and believe me, and understand that I can give. For me, there was no God born. Period. Kama pala. Neither there shall be after me. So, before him and after him, there is no God.
Right.
Amen. Say amen to that.
Amen.
There is no God before him and after him.
Amen.
Next verse. I, personal pronoun, even I, am the Lord. Beside me, there is no Savior.
Amen.
Beside this, him. This God is speaking here. There is no Savior.
Amen.
Okay?
Yes.
Now let's go to the New Testament. Acts 37. 36. Therefore, let all the house of Israel know assuredly that God made the same Jesus whom you have crucified. Both Lord and Christ.
Amen.
So if the God of the Old Testament say there is no Savior, there is no God, what about Jesus Christ? The Bible say there is no contradiction.
Yes.
So if there is God is the Savior, and Jesus Christ is the Savior, tell them what I save you. Listen, the Bible, no contradiction.
That's right.
How we can save you? Leviticus
because of the blood.
10. Verse 11. Later. Whosoever man shall be of the house of Israel, or of a stranger that sojourn among you that eateth any matter of blood, I will set my face against that soul that eateth blood, and I will cut him off among his people. For the life of the flesh is in the blood, and I have given it to you upon the altar to make an atonement for your soul. Amen. Where is the blood that make an atonement to your soul? So, in order for you that your soul can be atoned, you need the blood. Amen. According to his own word. And God, in his spirit, has no blood.
That's right. Amen.
You're getting it?
Yes.
See, he said, there is no God before me, after me. There is no Savior. So, to fulfill this scripture, Hebrews 9:22. And all these things are by the law parts of blood, and without shedding blood, there is no remission.
Amen.
Your sin will not be remitted unless there is blood sacrifice. Amen. So God, in the Old Testament, he has the blood. So he has to make a body for himself. Kailangan niya magdugo.
Amen.
Are you getting it?
Amen.
And he come down in a body of flesh.
Amen.
See, he made that body for himself. Yes. And he goes to that body and name it Jesus Christ.
Amen.
For the blood of Jesus Christ. So you can be atoned. That's why now you can say no to every word of God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Wala ka ng question sa Lord?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
See, there is one God. He's the Almighty One. Jehovah, the Great I Am. The Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. Now they have God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Ghost. Three gods. Impossible.
No.
There is one God.
Right.
There is no such thing. It's paganism.
Yes,
that's
pagan.
Right. Yes. That's right.
But they think they're right. It's three offices or dispensation of manifestation of that one God, the same God who covers all eternity.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
God wanted to be in a man.
Yes.
In the spirit, he can die.
That's right.
He can die in the spirit. He cannot bleed in the spirit.
Yes.
So he has got to make the body of flesh.
That's right.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
And sabi nga niya, tinuloko pala ng Diyos sa sarili niya. You don't know what you're saying.
Yes.
Is there any other way that you can go to heaven other than the sacrifice?
No. Yes.
No other way.
No.
You cannot go back to heaven because you're a sinner.
Yes.
Yes. Naman, nakakamali ka pa.
Yes. Amen. That's right.
So God has to take your sin to himself.
Yes.
And give you the righteousness of God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Let the righteous inside.
Amen.
Yes. Amen.
Hallelujah. Satan is only in you, he can go like this.
Amen.
But praise be to God, we are mga believer in this
case.
Kapanawaan nyo na redemption class ng Panginoon.
Yes, amen.
You will understand what God has done for them.
That's right.
Hallelujah. So, it's all God who did it for you. You don't do it anything by yourself. You just simply believe.
Yes.
Right. Hallelujah. God wanted to be in a man. He wanted to worship and fellowship with men. Then he overshadowed a virgin called Mary,
yes,
created in her womb a blood cell, and it developed and brought forth a man, which is was called Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Yung hindi mo nakikita, pakita.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Pakita.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hindi mo sinasabi ng Bible yan?
Yes.
Christian. First letter of John.
What?
That which was from the beginning, which we have heard.
Yes.
We have seen with our eyes.
which we have looked upon in our hands and handled the word of life. Nahawakan na. Nakikita na. Natin narinigan na mabali-balitaan lang.
Amen.
Hallelujah. The Bible says it was manifested in the flesh. That's what the Shin, the Almighty God, dwelling in a man, in a place like you and me. Hallelujah. That's the only way that He can save you.
Amen.
There is no other way. Your righteousness, that's why you're called worms.
That's right.
Hallelujah. You cannot help it. You cannot go to heaven by yourself. But somebody goes for us. Father, sagot po na kasalanan ni Brother Henry.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. He made the blood sacrifice. Whenever you commit sin, mabanggalan ko sa dugo.
Kaya
po ni Brother Nestor, mabanggalan sa dugo.
Amen.
Sabi ni Shailan, okay lang, kaya nakakansyawan siya doon. God is being pointed a finger by Shailan.
No problem.
Ayan ako, si Brother Romy. Brother Romy, nakatahimik dito. Kasi ko, si Brother Romy, nakagawa na kasi. Okay, natin man, tinamotin naman yung ginagawa nung. Ano ginagawa ni Brother Romy? Alin?
Hindi ko
na yung kita. Hindi ko na
yung kita.
Hallelujah. Okay, you're paid, but you should not be abusive.
That's right, amen.
Hindi na tinitingnan ang Panginoon niya. Hindi na hindi na righteousness. Listen, pag hindi mo na ituro, listen to this, pag hindi mo na ituro sa congregation mo, sa mga anak mo, mamamatay kayo na.
Correct.
Let the teaching come from God. I'm taking the teaching coming from God.
Right.
Taking the teaching coming from myself, from the Bible.
Yes.
So if you're taking teaching coming out of man, you think God will respect that? No.
No.
Hallelujah. That's not my word.
Right.
Kaya sabi ni Brother Pong, saan kayo na-baptize? I baptize in the name of Father, Son, and Holy Ghost.
Not yet.
In the name of Jesus. What is that in the Bible? Wala na, hindi naman sagot. Listen, sa isang, sa paggamit ng scripture, kailangan huwag kasumablay. Kailangan wala, hindi mo pwede mispoint ng scripture.
Yes.
You cannot mispoint the scripture and put it in the right place. You'll have to answer to God. And God will not manifest the word to the person.
That's right.
Hallelujah. Bakit kayo nagkaganyan-ganyan? Brother Chris, noong araw, error daw yun sa mga anak. Sabi ni Brother Noah, ng mga anak, si Papa na ba yun?
Hallelujah.
And binago siya ng Panginoon eh. All of us has been changed by God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. It's not yet totally, but it will come to perfection.
Amen.
Yes. That's why the Bible says, God was in Christ, reconciling the world to Himself.
Amen.
Jesus Christ is the body that God dwelt in. He gave up His life, and through that pure blood, He sanctified you and me.
That's right. Amen.
Inayos niya yung pananampalatayan niyo. Inayos niya yung pagtawad niyo. Inayos niya yung kaayosan niyo. Change your belief.
Amen.
Hallelujah. That's the blessing God. The God that Moses took in the burning bush. The God with Jeremiah. The same God in you.
Amen.
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 Hallelujah. It's not another person.
That's right.
Now they put Jesus Christ second person.
Oh,
where is that in the Bible?
Right.
Because of the word sitting in the right hand of God. That shows you lack of revelation. Mm-hmm. Okay, nakikita kayo, tinan mo, nakaupo sa kanang kamay. Ano ba, nakaupo, nakatayo, nakahiga. I'm lost with this Trinitarian doctrine. See, Jesus standing at the right hand of God. You can see, sitting down at the right hand of God. You can see, right hand of power. Right hand of God means power and glory of God.
Amen.
It doesn't mean that there is another person sitting down with another person.
Oh,
see. See, now,
The apostle were given the revelation of Jesus Christ. That's why they are told to wait.
Yes.
In the upper room. If Peter, during that time were given the revelation, and the rest of the apostle, kailan na bagong revelation? Tell me. When did it change? When did the Father, Son, Holy Ghost come into existence? Yeah, you go back to history.
Right.
Sino nakakaalam yan? The bride of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
They will go and baptize the Father, Son, Holy Ghost until Jesus Christ comes.
Right.
But there is a bride that will be important.
Thank you,
Lord. Amen. Right. Amen. For the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Now the word of Jesus Christ. See, tinan nga natin yan, Matthew 1:18. Mahal ka na.
Okay.
Sino tatay ni Jesus Christ?
Holy Ghost.
God is His Father, right?
God, yes.
He said, Father, forgive me, but they don't know what they are doing. Sigurado kayo?
That's right.
Sigurado kayo yung Father niya, yung God?
Amen.
Diyos na ba, sigurado kayo? Are you sure that... Are you sure?
Yes.
Because he said, God, my father is the typist, right?
Yes.
Sure that God is his father, huh?
But
let's read this. Now the birth of Jesus Christ was on this wife. When as his mother Mary was exposed to Joseph, before they came together, she was found with the child of the Holy Ghost. Ang tatay pala niya, Holy Spirit. Sino tatay niya? God the Father or Father the Holy Spirit? If there is three gods, dalawa yung tatay niya. Illegitimate pala si Jesus Christ. Sino yung tatay niya? Now, when she came together, they were found with the child of the Holy Spirit. That shows the Father and the Holy Spirit is the same Spirit of God. And Jesus is the Son that will come to manifest God in the earth. I call it Jesus. That's why there is no name given among men under heaven in which we will be saved, and only the name of Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
So if you are baptized in the name of Father, Son, Holy Ghost, hindi ka na bautismoan. Hallelujah. Inulit mo lang.
Hallelujah.
See? Your body is not eternal. Eternal means no time.
Right.
There was some time before the foundation of the world. God is thinking. You believe that?
Right.
The eternal spirit existed for billions of years.
Yes.
There was some time before the creation of man. God is thinking.
Amen.
Wala dong libro na nakasulat.
No.
He said, the Lamb's Book of Life is not a book. It's
right.
It is, no,
that's right.
There is no such thing.
That's right.
It's in the mind of God.
Amen.
Oh, hallelujah, I like this. So there are people on this earth. Listen, there are people on this earth who's in the mind of God.
Amen. Oh,
yes.
Amen.
Nung lumabas kayo sa mundo, ano tawag ko sa inyo? You are the expression of God in your time.
Amen.
That's why pinoproclaim mo si Jesus Christ sa aking panahon.
Yes.
You are the light of that day.
Hallelujah. Because you are the spoken word. In the God, people that are the expression of God.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Ang narinig ko yun. Kaya binay ko study ko. Predestined ka na may self-will na wala eh.
Yes.
Wala kasing gagawin. You will not do anything to say, but say yes.
Yes.
You have the word of God, the mind of people.
Amen.
Because you are made like that.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Para mga ano? Si Jesus Christ, kailangan niya dumando sa crucifixion, right?
Yes.
Kailangan niya kasi that's the Son of God. Ipipigilan ni Peter.
No, hindi pwede.
Pinagawa niya, he got the ears of the, listen to this, sana may makita kayo.
Yes.
He got the ears of the
God. Nagalit si Lord.
Yes.
Balik na yung spada mo.
Yes, that's right.
Pagpigilan mo ba yung matupad yung scripture?
Yes.
Binalik niya. Parang ganun din sa inyo. Hindi niyo alam. Ipawati-wati ka siya sa mundo ng kasalanan.
Yes. Mini.
Ha? Mini-mini. Pero narinig mo yung tawag sa iyo.
Hallelujah. Once I was lost.
Binando ka sa isang pagtuturo na ay, tagal-tagal nyo na dito. 25 taon na kayo, hindi nyo pa alam yung Book of Revelation. Mr. Mila.
Amen. Yes.
Narinig niya yung kakay niya tumatawag na sa kaya.
Yes, that's right.
Amen. Without God calling you out, hindi kayo makakalabas yan.
Father.
But you, in the mind of God, there'll be some Brother Henry that will come.
This
time ganun. Pwede sila si Ian eh.
Yes, amen.
There'll be Brother Ernesto that will come. There'll be Brother Erwin at Lutaro. Hallelujah. Uupo sila dyan.
Yes.
Kasi sila rin pag may nakaupo dyan, galit. Hindi na nagsasakay.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Huwag niyo upo niya. Atin
yan.
Huwag niyo pababayaan na may pumukli pa.
Yes!
Amen.
Ito sa sabihin ko. Huwag niyo pababayaan. God bless somebody. Take your place at the New Jerusalem. Meron kayong mga naka. Meron kayong mga naka. Yung kaluluwa mo.
Yes, yes.
Amen.
So, amen.
Yung kaluluwa mo ang hinahanap ng Panginoon.
Amen.
Somewhere in this time, you think of your soul. Ang dami kaluluwa, dami. May mga hobby ba mga artista, bakit hindi na pinili niya? Amen. Sa sexy ng mga artista, bakit hindi na pinili niya? Bakit pinili niya yung misis ko?
Amen.
Amen.
Bakit ikaw? Maganda ka na nga eh.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Kung medyo pangit ka, alam mo bakit ka sa harap ng Panginoon? Maganda ka pa rin!
Yes!
Walang pangit na gaganda sa sasidot ng sugat.
Hallelujah!
Bakit nagpapaganda yung tao? Why? Why they put coloring? Garnish. Why?
Para mapansin. Kasi
wala
na.
Hallelujah!
Labor talaga yung diablo, you know?
Yes.
The word is a thought express. That's why when you speak the word today, you will not speak your own language.
That's right.
You will not speak your own idea. You speak about what the Bible says.
Amen.
You are an expression of God in your age.
Amen.
John 10:28 say, my sheep hears my voice. Only the sheep can hear His voice.
Amen.
Only the sheep. If you are not sheep, you cannot hear His voice. Hallelujah. And I give them eternal life.
Amen.
And when your body is destroyed, you got a theophany waiting for you.
Yes. Right. Amen. Right. Amen.
Sabi ng prophet, yung theophany nyo, dumalaki. Hindi ko lang kung tumataas o but I don't believe that. Mr. Say, napupunog. You confess to the message, wala kang alam. Ngayon, punong ka na. Ngayon, pag punong-punong ka na, hinap ka na, na-rapture ka na ng Panginoon.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I doubt kung may nagtuturo ng Diyopan sa Dua, wala. Hallelujah. So when Jesus Christ come, if you are dead, listen to this. When Jesus Christ come, if you are dead, your theophany and your earthly body will join together.
Amen.
Be a glorified body.
Yes.
Hallelujah. You will have a glorious body like Him.
Amen.
I'll be a glorious, glorified body. Have an idea? Parang batang bagong panganak. Di ba yung batang bagong panganak? Bambu. Mula-mula. Hallelujah. Ewan ko lang kayong mga Africans. Ang sure ay laro.
This baby. Oh, yan yun. Kaya magkakaroon lang nandun yung bride.
Hallelujah.
Kailangan mo na yung kapwa mo. Kailangan mo na yung kapwa mo. Yung mga kilala ko dun. Kasi papayat ako. Hindi ko mula yung mga... Pero hindi mas guwapo ako ngayon. Kasi yung kapwa mo. Kami ko nung araw na. Kasi paipet ko. Wala akong laman sa ano. Sana ganito na rin ako ma-rapture. But how can they see? The seeing is an understand, right? Seeing to understand. So if somebody will not explain to you, you will not understand.
That's right.
So to see, that's why the Bible says, unless you are born again, you cannot see the kingdom of God because you cannot know the plan of redemption. You cannot know why man sin. You cannot know the redemption plan of God. You cannot know how what is Father, Son, Holy Ghost. You cannot know salvation. You cannot know presence. You will never know anything. That's why to see is to understand.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's why he said, when he, the Holy Ghost, comes, can you, John 16, verse. See, the Lord is speaking here, to the apostles. But I have yet many things to say unto you, but you cannot bear them now. Hindi niyo ako maintindihan. So it's the same thing with the person. If he don't have the Holy Ghost, he will never understand.
That's right.
However, when he, the Spirit of truth, is come, he will guide you into all truth.
Amen.
For he shall not speak of himself, but whatsoever he shall hear, shall he speak, and he shall show things to man.
That's right.
Kung ba kayo tataka, alam natin yung mangyayari sa future. Kaya ito mangyayari ng Diyos, kasi marareveal ng temple, magkakaroon ng ecumenical movement, magkakayos yung mga churches, lulubog yung California. Hindi ba naiintindihan bakit? Bakit naiintindihan natin? Because the Spirit of God pinahayag sa atin.
Amen.
Hallelujah. But that's why this principle is what the Pagano left, the Catholic left, the Catholic left, the Lutheran left, the Lutheran left, the Methodist left. So for the city of the Pentecostal. Hallelujah. And you don't come out. This denomination is the teaching. Kakaroon ko sa Hawaii ng judgment.
That's right.
Alam niyo yung pilahan? Kami pilahan sa sinya. Pilahan ng bigas.
Pilahapura. Nauna.
Pilahan ng sa LRT. Kawa ng pila. Gusto mo kapag sa sinya.
Gusto mo na.
Pag tayo sa Hawaii ng judgment, gusto mo sa uli ka. Asan yung pastor ko? Nandito ako sa uli. Oh my! Ang layo sa teaching ng Bible, no?
Amen.
Eh, meron tayong kapatid si Brother Benji. Brother Benji, he was just plain believer. Sinabi ni Brother Benji, may pastor na medyo mamalaki. Sabi ni Brother Benji, Pastor, can I ask you a question? Yes. So why don't you ask me? Nasaan ka? Sabi na. Sa kanan, siyempre! Sa kanan, naman sa kaliwa, kaya sa damnation niya. Ako, wala. Nasa right, nandun sa gitna. We can stand judgment. You may be the one to judge.
Amen.
Ayaw kumari mo na sinyera mo, lagot yun.
That's right.
Yes! Lagot yun. Pag hindi niya, listen! Pag ang tao, nangako ka, nagliligaw kayo ni Jesus na Fed, pag nangako si Brother Ray, tutupad siya sa pangako, hindi, babastin mo siya. Tama hindi?
Tama.
So, kailangan, nanunuyo siya, sagutin mo yung panunuyo, dahil gusto mo rin siya, di ba?
Amen.
Pero hindi ganun yun sa ligaw ngayon. Liligawin kayo ng Panginoon para sa kingdom of God. You say amen to the word of God. Huwag mo tatanggihan.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Because she is a creator of the universe. Tapos na to. Tatanggapin mo lang.
Amen.
It's already finished. It's just,
yes.
I've done it already for you on the cross. You just accept that what I did for you.
Amen.
So you pass the judgment. Hallelujah. But when you tell this to everybody, he will drop you down. That's why kokonti kayo.
Amen.
Thank you,
Lord.
Hallelujah.
Yes, God.
But no problem. God will catch you. When God said, I will restore what the caterpillar had eaten.
Amen.
What the cankerborn, all the cankerborn has eaten, I will restore. He said, only the children will be restored.
Amen.
That's right. Only the children of God, you will not be restored.
Yes.
Hallelujah. If you're listening to this end time message and you're accepting it, God restored you to the original.
Yes. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
See, the day of our Lord is coming here. When he was here on this earth, he has peace with many unbelief. All in his time, Brother Branham in his time, only preach the true pure gospel. See, they face unbelief. This message face the whole minister insect.
That's right.
Did not stop. Hallelujah. Those who preach the gospel, Paul, apostles, and Branham, they are all in glory waiting for us.
That's right.
But I'm glad. I'm glad pinaabot niya sa atin ng mensahe.
Amen.
Listen, I want to ask you a question. Did this message affect your life?
Amen.
Amen. Again, is this message affect your life?
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen. So it's from God. Huwag na kayo around.
Amen.
This message is coming
from
God.
Amen.
And you will keep the purpose of God in your life until He takes you out of the way.
Amen.
Yes. See you in the rapture.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Salamat malam. Ira ng isa ko sa isa ko siya pala. I see in the rapture.
If we never meet again on this earth, my precious friend, it is in God in heaven to
lose.
But if we meet again on this earth,
Your soul. Thank you.
Ang pasa ng aking mga pamilya po. Paano po kayo nabag sa amin? May ayaw po pag-ing ilaw kami sa i-display namin ng tokoy sa aming pamilya. Nalapit na po ang araw ay dati po kami na puso namin sa inyo mga kasing pare. Ginawan po yung mga bagay ng Panginoon ang pumunta siya. Pagay niyo na po. Hallelujah. Lalo sa mga bagay na kailangan namin sa laman. Surrender po namin sa inyo lahat. Lahat po sa amin. Kung mga desisyon namin sa buhay, na kami pupunta sa Panginoon. At ang bago kami, ano po din namin po. Pupunin na kami mga anak, mga regal. Pero over lahat namin po sa inyo. Panginoon, alam niyo po ang bagay. Pupunin para sa amin. Salamin po. Church, ito, Father God, sa inyo po bless ang mga tao ng Panginoon. Inyo po sila na sigla sa pagdating ng Panginoon. Sila yung nakakalimutan nyo sa mga sa inyo sa dito. Sabihin nyo sa mga anak ninyo, ang mga magiging na kahanap ninyo, magiging na kahanap ninyo. Hallelujah. Kaya sa inyong pagbaling, mayan na po namin ang mga kasama. Sa inyo po kayo nga, Panginoon, salamat po sa kami. Sana nagtawa kayo. At ito yung mga promise, can you close the service?
Afternoon for your grace, Lord. Thank you for your love in our lives, Father. We thank you for bringing us together again in your presence.
Amen.
And I thank you, Lord, that you led us through this morning, Lord God, and this wonderful message that we received on the pastor, Father. We thank you, Lord, for anointing him so much, oh God, to talk to us, oh Lord, directly from you, Lord. Bless your name, Father. And I pray that let this word sink deep in our heart, Lord.
Amen.
And when we go home, Father, but let us put it into practice, oh Lord. So, Father,
yes, Lord.
Thank you, Lord God. Be with us along the way, Father. As we go home, Father, be with us, Lord. Help us along the way, oh Lord. In all our endeavors, oh Father, be with us, Lord. Thank you because we know you have said our prayers, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Because we ask it in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen.